Hello dear viewers, in this video tutorial I'm creating a simple internal combustion engine piston using Autodesk Inventor Professional. I'm starting with a drawing, a two-dimensional drawing at a plane. The first thing to do is to create the basic profile of the piston in order to revolve it later to create our solid. So making the skirt, then the grooves for the oil and combustion rings. Should be 2 millimeters the distance. Should be 4, but I'm going to dimension it later. Should be 3. Should be 5, 4, 3, 3, the two at the top are for the combustion ring and the oil ring, the big one. So right now it should be 4 millimeters. The distance from, I have to make first the X and Y axis visible. So this distance is 27 and this is 45. This distance is 37. And for the top of the piston we need an arc like this, let's say. This point should also be coincident with the y-axis. And we need to add some more. Give some more information about the piston. This point and the axis should be 44 millimeters. This should be 62. What else? This distance here should be 46. And the last thing we need is to give the radius of this arc. This should be 189 millimeters. So at this point we are ready with the basic profile. Going to finish to exit the sketch and then revolve this geometry. I should have made this line as a construction line. So I'm going one more time to the sketch and I'm going to make this line a construction line. Now I'm going to revolve this area, surface to the axis, 360 degrees. Now we have the basic geometry of the piston. The next thing to do is to create the support for the wrist pin. So I'm going to make a new sketch in this plane. The only thing that we need is just a circle the center and this diameter should be 38 millimeters or a radius of 90 millimeters. In the center, I'm exiting the sketch and I'm going to extrude this area. Both sides symmetric through all. Okay. Now we have to remove some material from the center. So I'm going to make an offset from this plane. Actually, this plane is the center of the piston. So I'm going to create at this plane a simple rectangle. These two lines should be symmetrical. And this should be 40 millimeters. I'm finishing the sketch and now have to use the extrude feature in order to remove material. I have previously made this cylinder. This was 38 millimeters, so a total of 40 millimeters should be okay. Should remove the whole material as we see. That looks good. At this point, I'm going to create a new plane with an offset from the set plane. This offset should be the radius of the piston. This is 46 millimeters from plane. Sorry, I'm going to delete. So we will need the let's see. Yes, that's the right plane. So a new plate with an offset of 46 millimeters. This means that this plane is tangential to the outer cylinder of the piston. So I'm making a new sketch. This should be a hole with a radius of 11 millimeters. Okay, at the center point, and I'm extruding this the surface. I'm going to cut. We have to remove material. Wall. And now we have our hole for the wrist pin. One more thing to do is to create both sides of these holes a groove for the secure pin, the safety pin of the safety of the wrist pin. So I'm going to use one more time the offset plane. This plane, let's say 2 millimeters, and at the last axis, a plane. Sorry, I'm going to create a circle for the groove, let's say um, 12mm radius. I'm editing the sketch, and this should be 2mm. So now we have the groove for the secure for the safety of the pin. I'm going to mirror this groove to the other side using the mirror feature. So I'm selecting the groove and then the plane. Let's see which one. This plane is right. Okay. Actually, the geometry is ready. I can add some more details. For example, this one could be 6mm, somewhere or more. Let's say 8mm. I will round the areas here. Here, and let's see. Here, let's say 4mm. Okay, this looks better. So now the basic geometry of this simple piston is ready. If you enjoyed my video, like and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching.